Hello friends, today we are going to create another video which is a backend video for our React Native application, which was the example which I have given you I think 1 year back, which was like sign up navigation and sign in pages. So for that application we are going to create a video here which will be totally dependent on the backend. So I think this video will be very long, so follow with me because I will be coding along with you guys. Okay, so let's start here. So this is my code editor, which I think I have one application already, which I will delete, move to trash. So not required. Okay, fine. I'll create a new folder. The name will be React Native, PACKEND. React Native backend. We will navigate to this folder inside our terminal, which is this cdrm. Yes, we'll do npm init to create a package.json file. Everything will be yes, yes, yes. The package.json file will be there inside which you can see the name, version, name, whatever, whatever, whatever. And for creating the backend, we will use an Express framework, which is a Node.js framework, which is very good framework also. And I guess you guys might be aware of it. This is a save flag. It adds an entry into the package.json of the module which we are installing. Express. Let it take its time. Meanwhile, we will explore MLab. This website is required for creating a database as a MongoDB. Okay, we'll see. Alright, so the express.js is there. Now we'll create a new file. The file name can be anything, server.js, index.js. So I will write index.js. Inside this, the first step I will take is I will import Express library using require, which is I think a very old method of importing libraries. I will choose IRE require EXPRESS. I will create an instance of this equal to Express, and now the app will listen to a port the port can be TTTT as of now, and a callback function will be a log inside which we will pass a string. Server is RUNNING on PORT port. Till now we have created a server, and now we'll run this server. For running the server, we will write node index. Server is running on port 3333. We'll check here if we are right. Localhost, okay, cannot get slash, so it does not get the slash route. We'll provide it, no problem. app.get slash, and then again a callback function which will have two parameters, request and response. Again we'll use the arrow function which does not bind this, and this I said just for your reference guys. Response.send will send, we can send anything which will print whatever we send here onto the browser. So for now we'll send hello and INS friends. INDS spelling I guess is correct. Now if I will refresh, nothing will happen because we have not restarted the server here. So we'll restart the server like this. We'll go here and then refresh it. Hello friends is there. But there is one problem. If we change anything here like hello there, and we'll refresh the page, it is not going to render here. So for this problem can use NodeMon. NodeMon also is a npm library, and which gives you a functionality of not canceling your server and restarting, but simply you can NodeMon, use it once, and it will run the server whenever you save the file. NodeMon index, I think it will take some time. Yeah, the server has started. Refresh it. Hello there. Okay, hello. RGS. RGS. It automatically refreshed the application, and here, yes. So one of the problems has gone. Second is the folder structure. So the first folder that I'm going to create is controllers. Okay. Second folder is models, MODELS models. For now, third folder can be chalo DB. We don't have DB as of now, but it's okay, not a problem. Okay, so the first controller will be user controller dot js. Okay, we will use router, which is provided by the express.js library. So for that, we will go here, express ROU router. We will search if anything is available for us. We'll check route methods. These are the methods which we can follow. App.all, app.get, get, app.get, send, this, route handlers, then response methods, download and JSON, this send status, app.route. Okay, so for single route also you can do these things, express.route. Yes, this is what I was looking for. So I'm a big fan of copying and pasting. Change here, router. Okay. So now we have a router. First and foremost thing, module.export exports equal to module.exports equal to router. And then import this router inside this file as a user controller from reqir. Require the path of this file controller / user control. And I think I forgot one S here inside this. And we are good to go. Now, instead of using this, we'll use app.use / users. User, and the second parameter will be this controller, user controller. So we'll fetch the routes from user controller. And we'll do this. As of now, there is no routes, so we'll check what is going to happen. User cannot get user. Absolutely fine, no problem. Now we will create one single route, test route. Also very simple, router dot get simple plain route. Second will be callback function. The first and second parameter as request and response respectively. And oh shit, curly braces. And what we'll do, response dot send something. This is a user route. This is a user route. We will refresh the application to check if the user route is absolutely fine. Second thing is, now we will create our routes right here. and later we will write the functions required for them. So first will be route.post, because we will post some data from the client side, and the data will be create user. Create, instead of writing user, we will write simply create. First parameter will be request, second parameter will be response. Inside this function, we will write some more functions which will create the user and save their data into the database. Second will be login. Third will be log out. L-O-G O-U-T. So instead of post, this can be T-E-L-E-T. Get request. This can be post, this can be post. And one get request will be so we will create one get request of the user's data afterwards. First we will finish these three things. So for create, login and logout, we will save the data into the MongoDB server. So for MongoDB server, we have a MLab server. It was here. MLab. So for that we will do a fresh sign up. Let's see, because when I have not done it since a long time, so it will be a refresh for me too. Let's see, email can be named. No. Just only @gmail.com. First name can be hello my name. Last name can be also my name. Password can be not this one. What should I write? Simple password. Create an account. Almost create an account. Setting up. So wait, no problem. I don't have any problem. Create new cluster. Build my first cluster. Get started the video. Okay, fine. We'll go with cloud provider. Chalo, AWS is fine. We select Asia, Hong Kong, Tokyo, Mumbai. Free trial available. Very good. That is what I require. Select multi region workload as not required. Cluster tile. Free for everything. That is what I want. Additional settings. No backup. Don't do anything. Cluster name can be, once your cluster is created, you won't be able to change its name. Okay, no problem. I don't want to change the name. So we will write some name. Cluster name can be test CLUS. Any name. Chalo, yeah. Cluster is good. Test cluster. Create cluster. Something happened. Your cluster is being created. New cluster. Okay, so once the cluster will be created, we are going to use it. We'll connect it with the database. So for connecting the database, we will use one library. The name of the library is, Mongoose. Mongoose. So first we will install the Mongoose in our RM backend application. Installing is easy with the save flag, which will add an entry inside the package.json file. M-O-N-G-O-O-S-E. Mongoose. Meanwhile, we'll go to the Mongoose website to see the documentation of how to connect MLab. Sorry, not MLab, but the database MongoDB server with our Node.js application. NGO
Mongoose. ODM. Read the documentation, discover plugins. First of all, I need this. Require Mongoose. This is what the required thing as of now. Tell me. I'll copy it. And I'll create a file here. File name will be dv.js. So in this file, we will import what? One more mvg port. Let's see. Mongoose. We'll do require Mongoose. 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 Then, okay, fine. So, yeah, first we have imported the Mongoose already. This line is not required. Mongoose connect is the okay. So, we'll create one more constant, which is a MongoDB URL. This will be the URL. This is something MLAB URL. Here you are going to paste it. And this will be, compulsive. This is going to be available here. Mongoose URL. Then we have to export is a symbol Mongoose. And database file has been created successfully. We have to just check it by providing this MLAB URL, which we will see afterwards. And, so the database file will be something like this. We have imported the Mongoose. This will be the MLAB URL. We are connecting the MLAB URL with the Mongoose like this. Mongo URL, new user parser, something, I don't know. Mongoose.export, we have exported the Mongoose correctly. Then we have exported it, we have to import it in somewhere, which is a index.js file. And so let's get inside our index.js file and import our database, which is this. Instead of this, and right here. Mongoose required db. That's it, I think. And we have connected to the MLAB. So let's go to MLAB and check what. Create your first database user. Create your first cursor done. Create your first database user. Database access. Click here to manage your project's database. Okay, fine. But how to create it? I can't see anything. Just connect. Status charging jar, message document not found, no problem. So loading. Okay, so let it load. Till then we will explore something more. Which is okay. So now we need a skill also, which is a model. For that we'll create a new file, which is user.js. It's taking a lot of time. Well, then we'll import again MONGOOSE on use carry requires. Mongoose, and the second thing which is required is nothing as of now. Let's see how to create a schema. This will be loading. How much time? Create a database user. Set up a database user permission authentication credential in order to connect your cluster. Yes, user. What is this? JS this password contains special characters which will use URL encoded. Let's remove the. Okay, now add something is being done, say. So, whitelist your IP address. I don't know how to do that. So, what is to set it? I don't know. Two times created, I just made single one, so I will delete one. And it has deleted both of them. Wow. I don't know. This is a new design from MLab. So even I'm getting confused. Hello, to take the password as well. I don't remember the password as of now. Read, write any database. Okay. That's fine. Oh, access, add new custom role. I don't need any roles. Network access, add IP address. I don't want to add any clips. Advanced, not required. Access management. Okay, git permission. Okay, alert, setting, chart, switch. But where we will get the link of this database? I need a link so that we can connect it to our project zero. If the SAMLab method exists. Settings, where is nothing like a setting, project ID, project name, project time zone. Okay, so here is a dog. If you don't get anything, dog is available for you. Okay. Let's create a cluster for free, load sample data, deploy shared clusters, deploy a cluster cluster. Create a cluster, deploy a cluster, create one more user for your cluster. This is what I required. Okay, I did this. Choose connection method, create memory user, insert data, collections. This is something cluster, I don't know. Clusters, collections. Loading the mouse at a lake. So, the SAMLab has changed their design. It is getting very difficult for me to understand. So, interact with your data, load sample data. Load sample data as of now. Load sample data. Yeah, deploying our changes current. Okay, direct to the data. Let's start with whitelist your IP address. Don't know my IP address. Let the data define your schema. Okay, so this is how we are going to define our schema. Creating a model. Define the schema correct. So the first step we did already. We'll take the schema object from Mongoose like this. Instead of var, make it false because we are not going to change it. And there is a custom data. So, let's see, okay, so here is a block schema equal to new schema. Instead of this block schema, we'll change the name change the variable also, const user schema, new schema title not required, commit, which is not required. User schema will have first thing, which is a email name. Okay, which will be type string, body string, date, the permission, permitted schema type star here. Okay. So, first thing, first type will be string string, then create a model. Okay, let's create basic model also. Name, email, okay, POP type string, post, and then system ID. Password will be type definitely string, 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 and third name, email, password. That's what we required as of now. And we connected with the model like this, var, mr, const, type of const. Instead of log, we'll keep the capital user, which is a class kind of user. There, user schema will become, sorry, block schema will become user schema, and we'll save it. And if we have saved, so we have to export it also. Export command will be module.exports exports, and we will export an object. Of course, exports already an object. Okay, done. Now we have to import this user inside our user controller so that we can do some, we can execute some codes, const user, b user, and then we want, okay, so we are fetching it from model. I think we have to go one step back. Then /, user, if the spelling is correct, connect, and that's it. Now we will check our MLab again, if we have anything. I think we have a sample list of data. Very good. Create data list. Enter a database name, auth, db, collection name, users, capped collection, before MongoDB can save your new database collection, and must be specified at the time of creation. So, retrieving a list of database collections. This is a sample Airbnb. This is our new database. 7 databases, 1, 2, 3, 4. 7 correct collections memory. Overview. Real time. Fits. Collections. Real time. Upgrade your cluster. Get gain. Side metrics. Metrics means, I don't know what is. Connect instructions. Connect to your cluster. Methods to connect your application to your cluster. Let's see how to do this. Add your current IP address. Description. Okay. So ready to connect. Choose how you want to connect to the next. Choose connection method. Connect with the self. Connect your application, get a connection, string, and new driver connection examples. Connect with MongoDB Compass. This one is better, I guess. That's what I require. Copy it and paste it. Where we have to paste? Somewhere where I guess. Like this. Majority, retry true. Okay, here is your username. Here will be the password which you have given. Now I forgot what is the password I have given for it. So, let's check. Okay. I guess so. The password it should be capital, I guess. Okay. Now, get started. Okay. Everything is working fine. Let's see if this works. And see if there is no other problem. To handle promise mongo bad, authentication failed. I think we are connected with the server. So the second step that we are going to take is we'll create a user first. So for that we have to write a function which is a save function. You can move this, I don't want it anymore. First we have to we'll get the user from the request body. But how to get it from the request body? For getting it into the request body, I think we need an app. We need a body parser module. Body parser so that we can pass the body which we are passing in the request. NPM body parser. NPM body parser. Let's check this. NPM I body parser. We will tag it. Here it's this. And we will save it inside the package.json also. An entry. An entry is going to be there. So I think we are done. And then we have to check the documentation of this. Okay. Var body parser equal to body parser. Copy it. And paste it here. Instead of that, the const. Second thing, app.use, I think we have to do somewhere. Verify. Example, probably the example. Here, body parser, app.use, URL encoded. Let's use this also, content type. Check header content type explorer chart. Everything we have copied from there. And here we can copy pasted strings. Just remove the comment. I like comments, but right now it is not required here. App.use set header content type text name. This code, let's remove it, not required. And paste it after our imports. We also find a kind of import. We paste it here. And then we just have to check request.body. So we do on the log. Request dot UDI body what we are getting, and this command we have to pass it from the postman. So I think I have postman somewhere. Postman is disabled. Accept permission. We go here. That's we have a postman. Oh, shit. take me straight to the parent creator and fill down the form. Fill in all these letters, what required, so control V, copy, post request, create. So the request will be like post, then complete, local post, copy, postman, come the postman row, postman slash CREAT, create, and then we'll send the board body. Body will be the draw text JSON application, which is this, and send JSON will be like email, which is adc@xyz.com. Let's send this now only, but before sending we have to send the response also, otherwise postman will not get any response and it will be keep looping, keep fetching for the response. Got it. Okay, and we will see the data here somewhere. Then we will do send. Got it, came here. And request.body has email and correct. So request.body has the data which we want from the client side. Okay. As of now we require user, new user. We create a new user, so that is const user equal to new Isola user, and inside this I think we have to pass the data to save it. MongoDB, MongoDB instance, statics methods, create a model. This is find one new animal. Yeah, complete object will be type equal to dog. Console dog. Let's check any other example if they have. Install that. New schema. New schema. Create connection. Create. New person. New person. Correct. So the object will be like const data, then const user data equal to email, which will be request dot body dot email. Let's try to save this. Oh, we can save the password also. Create this body password. If it has request dot body dot PSS password. Pass this user data here. Okay, then we do user dot save dot then inside then you get the user, user and user let's stop saying user. Okay. else we can send status also, but send test HTTPS status 400. I think so. So we'll do like this. We try to say yes, please, yes, can be the ID password. Password will be something. Send again. I think we got email password correct. Absolutely correct. So the create user functionality is almost done. There are some more tricks that we have to do, but the create functionality is almost done. Now I will create the login, logout, and get the user details functionality in the next video. So please guys, do subscribe for being updated with the latest videos. Thank you and have a nice day.